MTN, everywhere you go.
Project Fame!
What's a feeling?
They want to follow my way. They want to follow my way. Suddenly, everybody wanna be.
You guys are looking fresh.
Fresh.
I think I'll go and chill with you guys, man.
Chilling. Yeah, well, for me, I'll say you guys have been watching. You guys are doing great. Proud of you guys. And no fight, no quarrel. You guys are doing really good. And I'll personally say thanks to Daniel. He did justice to my song. And trust me, yeah. I have it on my phone, you know. So nice one, man. And away from that, I would just want to say you guys should take this very serious, and because your life can change from here, trust me, you know. I want a talent hunt like this, and today the story is different. So this can land you somewhere very big. This is Inyanya, Chidima, Tiwa, all the way from Yankee, doing music, you know what I mean? This is Wheezy, all the way from Sumire, you understand me? You know, so this can take you to somewhere very big, so take it very serious. Tell yourself the truth, what you can do and what you can't do, right? So for me, I think I'm cool with you guys, and I'm looking forward to know the two people I chose among you.
Coming from a reality show myself, I didn't win. So, you know, regardless of what happens and regardless of who wins, I truly believe that all of you guys are winners. And you choose your career and how it goes. So even if you don't win, that's not the end of the road. In fact, that's just the beginning. So you guys, you know, this is a great platform. So I just want to encourage you guys to just, you know, keep going. Even if you don't win, please don't give up. Please.
I've never been on a talent on show, so I really don't know how it feels. But, you know, I know it comes with a lot of pressure. And, like, you know, you guys need to actually, you know, it's a competition still. I know you guys are friends, but it is a competition. So, like, it is a healthy competition. I want you to look at it that way. So you being here today, just know you're winners, man. Like, everyone knows your face already. So if you leave here, you can ride with whatever you have. Just trust me, man. Winning or not, trust me, that doesn't guarantee you're going to be the biggest star. So it depends on what you do with it after this. That is when the journey is just about to start. So you just need to, like, you know, kill it here, then kill it outside. So, man, I wish you guys the best. Looking forward to working with you guys. You guys have amazing voices, by the way. You guys have amazing voices, beautiful voices.
Depends on what you can do with what you have taken out of here. It depends on you, it depends on your spirit, it depends on how seriously you take it. And it doesn't matter if you win or not. A lot of winners have come out and you stopped hearing anything about them. So just do the best you can, know what you can do, know your limits. Do not try to overdo anything. Just stay where you are. You can try to challenge yourself once, twice, anytime you want, but just know what you can do, know your limits, and just go for it.
So that's what's up. To round it all up, you know, I always say one thing: winning talent shows is just a platform. It doesn't mean, like you said, it doesn't mean when you win you're the biggest star out there. You're actually just starting. You feel me? And for you to go to the next level, the only thing that makes you win when you go out there is passion. You know, are you just here because you have a voice? Or, and then when you win here, are you going to be out there because you're there doing what you love? Or you're doing, it's like, oh yeah, I won, so I have to sing. So it's two different things. But the winner will always stand out. You know, the best man will always win. And I wish you guys the best. So feel free to ask us questions and whatever you want to know. You just start, introduce yourself, and then,
my name is David. I'm from Ghana. And I want to know, you guys are stars. You actually? All right. But my question is, you guys go on stage now and then. When you get on stage, before you get on stage, what do you have in mind? How do you condition yourself mentally before you get on stage? Because I know you guys also face some kind of challenges with the crowd and all that, but how do you condition yourself mentally before you get on stage?
I don't know, but you know, for me, I'm sure we all have our tricks, you know, but for me, it's just, I'm going up there to have fun. I try not to look at it as, oh God, people are expecting so much from me, you feel me? I feel like, when I go up there, if I'm not enjoying myself up there, the people watching will not enjoy themselves. That's me. I don't know. They have their trick, but that it works for me.
Personally, I think the day that comes before you go on stage and you don't get nervous, trust me, I feel you already. Because it means that you don't care about what you do or you don't care about how you end up performing, basically. So being nervous is a good trait. You should always have that, but I mean, you should just be able to calm your nervous state. And when I get on stage, I just go there to entertain, to connect with the crowd, to make them understand what I'm talking about, what I'm singing. I try to bring them into the music, basically. So for me, I try to sing to myself. I try to entertain myself and make myself feel what I'm saying first, because if you don't believe what you're saying, trust me, no one would believe what you're saying. So you need to convince yourself and try and entertain yourself to be able to get to the crowd. So that's just it for me though.
Any other questions? Are you cool with that, Daniel? Good.
My name is Roland. I want to ask, how do you separate your... Okay. How do you... How do you separate your person from your stage person?
The truth is, I'm whiskey. There's never a day I'm like really IO. Do you understand what I mean? So there's really no time for me to really think about, oh, I'm a different person. This is a lifestyle, you know, performance, recording, shows, photo shoots, video shoots. That's like, it all comes with it.
I know what you're trying to say. You know, it's really easy. Like, it's very, very easy. Like, your teachers say, just put yourself into that song. Say like, okay, this is you. This is what you're going through. Go through your song. Interpret it yourself. Put yourself in that story. It doesn't matter how you are. Whatever you say on stage, whatever you do on stage, doesn't have to be how you are. So just put yourself there.
So if I got you right, you're saying, how do you say it? This is Ayo and this is whiskey.
Yes.
It'll happen, it's natural. It's just, you will, when the pressure of whiskey hits you, you will look for Ayo.
Trust me, it's crazy sometimes. Like,
you feel
out,
me,
like,
right?
Sometimes on a real, I actually want to share this experience with you guys. This happened like yesterday. It was so funny, right? I was going out, you know, and people were just looking at me. You know, like when you just see random people looking at you and like hitting your corner, I totally forgot. I'm not gonna lie to you guys, I'm actually being 100% serious. Like, I actually forgot. I was like, these guys are in my car now. Like, what's wrong with you? And I'm like, whiskey. I'm like, sorry, you know, like, so it's gonna happen sometimes, you know, definitely. But with time, you get into it, really. It's just a lifestyle, man. You need to understand that you're doing this for the rest of your life. That's if you choose to do it for the rest of your life, anyways. So, like, you know.
People's song, you have to interpret. You have to put yourself in that. If you're singing a Whitney Houston song, you have to do it your way. But when you get to the level where you're singing your own songs, it's different because you're telling your own story. So I don't have to go on stage and sing Kele Kele like anybody else. I'm the only person that's going to sing it the way I want it to sound. So eventually when you have your own songs, nobody else can sing it like you because that's your song. Now it might be a bit difficult because obviously you're doing covers and you're doing other people's songs. But eventually when you have your own material, you'll feel a little bit more comfortable with the transition into, you know, interpreting it. So.
Ladies!
Okay.
We know here in Nigeria, they say it's all about party, party. Yes, we love to party. I love to party. Like, seriously. But I want to ask, now, when we're singing, are we singing for the crowd or for yourself? Because, for instance, I could like something slow and good, but they'll say, ah, Nigerians don't like it, you must go this way. So, do you please yourself or please the listeners?
In Nigeria, to be honest with you, in America and the UK, pop music sells more than gospel, jazz, neo soul, any genre. It's popular, and that's why it's called pop music, because it's popular music. It's a little bit more watered down, but that doesn't mean it's not real music, because it's actually harder to write a pop song than it is to write a really deep, soulful, meaningful song. So, in all honesty, you have to decide that, you know, do you want to be a popular singer or do you want to stick to what makes you happy? But the reality is, there's a financial bracket. You know, if you're going to be true and say, I just want to be a gospel singer, I want to, you have to know that you might not make as much money as somebody that's singing a party song. But that also doesn't mean that you can't find a way to balance, you know, both. But I think that decision has to come from you, you know, what you want to do. If you want to entertain people, that's fine. But if you want to stay true to yourself, just know that you're targeting a niche market.
And the truth is, do you want to do slow music because you love it and you do show maybe once in 2 months or once in 6 months, or do you want to entertain people and make money and keep yourself going on? I remember when Nyaya did this, Nyaya was very, very good when it comes to singing, and after 4 years, Nyaya discovered another talent. You understand? That's the truth, you know, you have to be serious. Me too, I went through same process, you know. I was singing for my Calabar people, always Calabar songs, eating from Calabar every time. I do a lot of events, and trust me, you can do, you know, you can entertain the whole nation and the whole world and make good money. So ask yourself, like Tiwa said, what do you want? Some people want to keep standard. I don't want to go below the standard, no matter even if I'm hungry or not. Me, Casey, I don't want to be hungry. I want to entertain people and make money and also make people happy. So the key is, Nyaya can still sing, but he still want to make money. So ask yourself what you want.
People's vocal dexterities are different. Yeah. Sure. Not everybody can do pop. Some vocal textures can do pop, some can't do. But it's very key for an artist to be versatile. Versatility is very important in the industry. And you have to ask yourself, like I said, what is your aim? What is your goal? Like, sometimes, like, I still argue with people who say R&B can't sell in Nigeria. I would tell them, no, that's not true. I mean, I do R&B. I don't do dance tracks. But I know where I am today by God's grace. Yeah. I mean, we have the likes of myself. We have the likes of TV. We have the likes of Dari. We have the likes of Banky W. These guys don't really do party tracks. But trust me, they have their niche market. And trust me, when you have a niche market, you get paid for what you do. Even if, I mean, it might not come today, tomorrow, next tomorrow. But you have to ask yourself, what is it? What kind of music do you want to put out? How do you want to be remembered? And I think you should also have that behind your mind when making a decision. It's not about now. Because if you think about now, trust me, it will happen now, and tomorrow people will forget about you. I mean, that's why we have the likes of Bongo Sikwe, Onyeka Onwenu. We still, I mean, till tomorrow, I mean, we know these people are legends forever. So just, it's just about what your decision though.
There's a trick. Just do good music. That's all. Trust me. So just make sure your music is good.
You need Wizkid because you need Lil Mpopos. You need Kukeres.
That's what I'm saying.
I mean, but you also need Praise. You also need Bears. You also need Chidimmas. Like, you can't have a Nigerian industry with just the same genre of music because sometimes you want to listen to something deep. But sometimes I literally just want to go to a party and just hear party jam. So there's a space and a time for everything. So don't feel bad if it's also a calling. If God has called you to do something specific for a niche market, you can run from it all you want. You'll come back to the calling that God called you to do so.
Versatility is very, very important. Very, very, you can dabble into this, dabble into that whenever you want to, however you feel like. So just make sure you are versatile.
Like, you know, you have the bad times when your voice goes cracky and you have to perform on stage. How do you deal with it?
Number one, your mic techniques. You feel me? Because there are times, I mean, there's a way you use your mic. Trust me, it works for me. Sometimes I use my mic so close because my voice is very bad. So I want you to really hear me because I know if I do this, you win. So I know, like, your mic techniques is very important when you lose your voice.
I have to give it up for Nigerian artists because this is the honest truth. We work way more than any other artist in the world. You don't really see Rihanna singing at people's birthday parties or naming ceremony. You know, they'll go on a tour for like 2 months and then the other 6 months in the year, yeah, she's on a yacht somewhere. You know, but we are literally, if when you're not singing, you're not eating in Nigeria. So you're constantly working, and they also have tricks. They have their own sound engineer. They have pre-recorded vocals. You know, all these things that we don't have the luxury of, you know, of having. So it's just about knowing how to really pace yourself. You just have, I don't really think there's any tricks. As they say, you know, you shouldn't smoke and all these things, but all these art, like Aretha Franklin and these people, you know, they smoke and do, and they still sound incredible. You know, so I think it's 80% your mental state. Yeah.
Seriously, because they actually help. You think they might not help, but trust me, in the long run, they will help you. Because, like, usually I always refer to my season, and I had issues with my vocals and stuff, but I had to take my vocal classes, like, really seriously, and had to cut down on a lot of things like cold food and yelling. When you yell, you just tend to lose your voice. So stop yelling, avoid yelling too much, and take your vocal classes seriously. It will go a long way.
Who you are your mentors? You guys were singing and we picked two people each. So I will be working with Margaret and Johnny.
Don't do it that way. I will not be happy with you. No. The way we are going to do it, I think they should introduce themselves. Why they are introducing themselves? We are selected.
No. No. I wish. It would be nice to do that, but then. I'll be working. Please, if Johnny and Margaret, can you stand up?
Yeah. So this way, we'll just, you guys sit down here.
Okay.
Yeah, so let's do it that way. So no, I want everybody to
like two.
Yeah, then okay, we now nice. Yeah, it makes a lot of sense. So, Chidimma,
I like your name.
David and
Blessing,
I know those two guys sitting there. So you can move. Let's move. Okay. Let's do.
Okay. Tiwa, go ahead.
Olawale and Ayoka.
Yay!
Okay. Niniola. Roland. Okay. You sang Christmas Carol, right? Okay. I remember.
That'd be good.
Okay, Praise, go ahead. No, go. We see we go.
Tell you on your own.
She's gone.
Okay. Okay, well, I'll be mentoring Simon and Immaculate.
Okay.
That's Toby.
Oh,
hi, Doug. Doug.
I can see it. Okay.
So we're gonna have like a heart to heart
talk.
These faces will know who I am, cause I'll be a superstar. Did you see me in the magazines? Tell me, what did you think of me? I'm a celebrity. Don't you know, yeah, I break all the rules, but I figure that's what stars are supposed to do. Just cause I'm super cool. Don't you know, whatever time of day, be sure to find me in my designer shades. That's how I operate. Don't you know, if I had to do this.
I mean, I love you guys too. Don't get me wrong. I know.
Let's go.
Okay, God knows the win already.
Yes.
I have 10%. Right. Anybody that wins, you give me 10%.
This car. I'll just use your car for like 2 weeks. I'll return it to a scratch.
Okay.
This time I have fought so many battles, but I came through stronger.
I raced across the finish line. Yeah, I can hear the cheering crowd, and that only means one thing. I can let my breath go. I cannot believe, no, is it really me? Oh, I'm a winner, yeah.
Drums roll, feel my body explode. Gotta let the world know I'm a winner.
Sing my name in gold, I'm a winner. Let the whole world know I'm a winner. Even when my chances grow thinner, in the end I know I'm a winner. So let the lights go up, let the crowd stand up. Let me hear the sound, I'm a winner. So let the lights go up, let the crowd stand up. Time to take a bow. See my name in gold, I'm a winner. Let the whole world know I'm a winner. time to take a bow. I'm a winner. Yes, oh yes, oh yes, oh yes, oh yes, oh yes. I'm a winner. Yes, oh yes, oh yes, oh yes, oh yes, oh yes. I'm a winner.
If you know you're a winner, let me see your hands go oh,
oh, oh,
oh, oh. And if you know you're a winner, let me hear you say yes, oh,
yes, oh,
yes, oh,
yes, oh.
And if you know you're a winner, let me see your hands go oh,
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 oh.
And if you know you're a winner, let me hear you say yes, oh,
yes, oh,
yes, oh.
Meeting you guys.
Welcome again, my fellow contestants. I know. Yeah, we just had a wonderful session with our superstar mentors. You know, appreciate them once again. Yeah. Now, one by one, you come here to the seats. You give us the experience. You share with us how it went, how the session went with you and your mentor. I'm going to start with those that had sessions with Superstar KC. Oya Limpopo. Baby, baby, go Limpopo.
I just like to happy, oh, oh, my baby. Do they sweep me, oh, oh, my baby. Tonight, Oya Limpopo. Baby, make me go Limpopo. Oya Limpopo. Baby, make me go Limpopo.
Okay.
Also go Limpopo. So make me go Limpopo. Oh, yeah.
Almost on a long thing. Almost.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas,
just like the ones I used to know. Ba ba boo boo boo. Oh. May your dreams be merry and bright, and may all your Christmas may be white.
Looking out on a morning rain, I used to feel uninspired. And when I knew I had to face another day, oh, it made me feel so tired. Before the day I met you, life was so unkind. But you're the key to my peace of mind.
No, 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 no. We know you're jealous. Calm down. It's our time.
They asked the question. Just say.
Okay. Calm down. Now. When is your turn? You will do your own. We know. We know. We know. Okay. The interesting part is for me, am I talking for me or us?
No, you.
Okay. For myself, his kind of person is the kind of person I want to be on stage. So connecting with him for real was a great inspiration for me. He taught me how to remove my normal self from my stage self.
Some artists get on stage and they say, okay, I'm performing this song first, second, third, fourth, and they will stick to that, and the crowd is not feeling what you're doing. You don't need to. You need to change. Sometimes I change. At every point, you should calculate the crowd, how they're reacting. And I have a good manager. He also studied the crowd. You know, you need someone, even while you're on stage, you need someone that knows how to calculate the crowd.
He told us that most of the time when you're doing a song, you have to be in that character before you go on stage. If you're doing a sad song, be sad for that performance. And he also talked about a lot of hustle that goes beyond here, like promoting your songs, recording your songs. And the truth is, most of us, we come out of this place and the fame just lasts for a while. But most of us don't know what to do with it. He told us what we can do with this.
You know, so you need to do everything possible to keep the name and the face going, to keep the brand going, because you guys are brand. As I am, I see myself like a brand like MTN. I see myself like any brand out there. So I do everything possible to make sure I remain that brand. When they see you, what do they remember? Right now, if people see me outside, they do like this because I do Limpopo. Yes. And I created that in front of my mirror. I did it in my mirror. I'm like, it looks funny, it looks stupid. But whether they like it or yes, I did it in my first song, Opekete. Nobody answered me. I did it in the remix I did with Davido. They did not answer me. They kept quiet. But when I did it tour time in Limpopo, it became a hit song. And everybody's dancing it in the club anytime they play the song. So consistency is important, seriousness, and believing what you're doing. You know what I mean? So it's not going to be that easy. I won't lie to you. But the challenge is within you. Ask yourself and tell yourself the truth. Is this what I can do?
He talked about a lot of ways we can make money in the industry. He talked about the ladder.
Julius introduced us to these guys when we gave him a song, because we wrote a song on HIV. I can't even remember the song. HIV AIDS is a killer. This is a very stupid song, but it was mine. And when we did the song, they're like, oh, pretty nice. Then we started the tour with those guys. It was about Plantation Boys, The Remedies, all those guys then, Idris Abdulkarim, all of them. And when we went to the first show, I can't forget in Obudu, when we now did that a cappella, no beat. Who gave us money to enter studio? No money now. We did a cappella and they felt it. Idris now told us about the talent hunt. And that was how we registered for the talent hunt. We now won. And we won, we took it serious, and this is where we are today. Meaning, you need to leave your comfort zone. That's my story. You need to leave your comfort zone. Look for people to assist you. Look for people to help you. You need that ladder.
He said, you may come out of here and maybe people are not feeling you or hearing as much from you as they should. You promote your song. The truth is, your song cannot go around Nigeria in 1 day or 2 weeks, in 5 weeks. He said, from one person, you get connected to another.
If you get close to Casey, I can take you to a radio presenter. See, this is my friend. He has a good song. Play the song. You don't need to pay them to play. He plays the song. He likes the song. His colleague might ask him tomorrow. Man, that's the song you were playing yesterday. Very nice. I like that song. Go get the song. I need that song. I'll be playing it on my show. The song is getting the attention. Maybe everybody won't even know the song. You bring another song better than that one. Those guys already believe in you. They can preach your gospel. So it's a process. But you first of all need to believe in yourself. Leave your comfort zone. Look for help. Trust me, you'll get it.
And that's how it is. Some people are too shy to go and say, please, I want to sing in your program, in your show, or please, I need this assistance from you. He told us that you have to be humble. If those people don't come to meet you, you go meet them.
Project Fame! What a feeling!